गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। We'll start in a couple of minutes. Okay. So, in our previous class, we have discussed about the nervous system. We have covered in one slide the revision of the nervous system. Today, what we can do is that we can solve some questions from end of the chapter for the nervous system. Next class, maybe like you are saying that we can start this ecosystem chapter. Okay, we can revise the ecosystem. So today what we will do is we will do questions from this nervous system. Okay. First up, what prevents the weakening of impulses as they travel through the axon?
Myelin sheath.
Yes, just like a wire is carrying the electrical current, the axon is carrying the impulse on a neuron. So if it is not covered, then there is a chance that this electrical impulse, that voltage, that current, it can leak out. Okay, so that is covered by this myelin sheath, which is going to prevent the weakening of the impulse. Which of the following parts of the brain controls the balance and body postures?
Cerebellum.
Yes, cerebellum is going to control the body posture. The gray matter of the spinal cord consists of
both
the cell bodies as well as the dendrites. Okay, both will be there. How many cranial nerves arise from the brain?
12.
Okay, so 12 cranial nerves from the brain, and how many nerves the spinal nerves?
31.
Finalist. 31. Which of the following terms means a change in the external environment that evokes a specific reaction in the body?
Stimulus.
So, because the stimulus is a change in the external environment. Okay. Once there is this change in the external environment which is causing specific reaction, that external we say that it is a stimulus. Stimulus is causing a certain specific reaction of the body. The gaps between the myelin sheath is known as
nodes of Ranvier.
Human beings have dashed pair of spinal nerves.
31.
Dash are the extensions of the cell body of a neuron.
Dendrites.
The chemicals released during the transmission of impulses are called
neurotransmitters.
The spinal cord is the extension of the dash of the brain.
Medulla oblongata.
The cranial and spinal nerves are part of the dash nervous system.
Peripheral nervous system.
Good. Next, match the following myelin sheath.
Covering of axon.
Dendrites.
Extensions of the soma of the neuron.
Meninges.
Protective layer of the brain.
Okay, protective layer of the brain is the meninges. Spinal cord.
Reflex actions.
Yes. So the spinal cord, one of the main functions is the reflex action. Brain does not do it. Axons transmit impulses to the other neurons. Okay. define the nervous system, the parts of a neuron. Okay, now here in your annual exam, okay, it is going to be a 2 hours paper. Okay, total marks 90, section A, section B. Section A 40 marks, section B 50 marks. Section A will have maximum, each question will be 1 mark each. Okay. And here it will be anywhere from 2 to 5 marks each. Okay. So overall, in this way, that question paper will be arranged. Section A, section B, 40 marks, 50 marks. 40 marks will be mainly like true and false, fill in the blanks, and you know, single term. Okay. These kind of things will be there in the section A. Okay, where maximum it will be only 1 mark for each question. For section B, it will be like a definition. Okay, draw the diagram and label the parts. Okay, that kind of maybe for 5 marks. Okay, in between maybe what is the difference between two things, that can be for 3 marks. So in this way, between 2 to 5 marks each, the question will be there for section B. It will involve a little bit of a description writing. Okay, so in this way, the overall pattern will be okay. Next,
only 10 marks.
Yes, sir, 10 marks.
10 marks.
This is 10 marks.
Yes, sir, 10 marks.
This is 10 marks. Is it will be. Maybe internally, we don't know, but it will be set for 90. Okay. You don't have to
think about
those 10 marks. Okay.
So, diagrams which will be coming.
So, all diagrams are important, that is there in your textbook. And for your, like I told earlier, this is annual exam. In annual exam, the final term will have the more weightage compared to the previous ones. Okay, for previous ones already you are examined, you have written some exam. So more weightage will be there for the annual term, whatever those chapters are there. That is the circulatory system, nervous system. They will have the more weightage. Okay. So practice more. Okay, give more importance to the structure of the brain, structure of the heart. Okay, these kind of things you have to give more importance. Thorough labeling and drawing and making. Okay, so it's not very important that you should make, you know, fancy three-dimensional, highly colorful and all those kind of images. No? Anatomically accurate images, all those things are not required. What is there in your textbook? Okay, a legible and if you are able to make a diagram, label it properly, okay, that does the purpose. Okay, should not try to overdo also, it is not going to be very useful. So basically what you do is focus more upon, say, for the 5 marks questions. Obviously 5 marks questions will be labeling type of questions will be there. Okay, you have to draw the diagram and label it. And 2 marks questions will be generally like definitions. Okay, definition. And 3 marks question will be mainly like what is the difference between this and this. Okay, some kind of table you will make and you will try to 1, 2, 3 points. Okay, about how these two things are different. Okay, in this way you can do it. Okay, so for example, define the nervous system. Okay, it's a very big question, but define the nervous system. Okay, so 1 mark, 2 mark is meant. What are the parts of a neuron? Okay, name the parts of a neuron, make a diagrammatic representation of the neuron. okay, what are its parts, its role? That can be 5 marks question. Okay, so what you will do, you will make a neat diagram of the neuron, you will label the parts and write the function. What is the function of the sensory neurons? What is the function of the cerebrospinal fluid? What is the functions?
It cushion against the brain and prevents the brain from negative shock.
From the external impacts or shocks, okay? So it is providing protection to the brain. Okay, mechanical protection also it is providing. So write any two functions of the spinal cord. One important function of spinal cord is
reflex.
Yes. Another important one is a transmission of the nerve impulses from the brain to the body and from body back to the brain. In between, it is acting as a medium, right? So that is one thing. Differentiate between cranial nerves and spinal nerves. So like this here, it is asking like a difference between the two. So what you will do, cranial nerves, spinal nerves. Okay, so then you will write that, okay, how many pairs are there, and then from where they are starting. Okay, they are starting from the brain here, they are starting from the spinal cord. Okay, in this way 2-3 points you will be able to write. Define reflex action. Okay, direct definition is there in the textbook, so for 2 marks or like that you can write that. So wherever definitions are there in the textbook, you know, you try to follow that definition. Okay. Sometimes students can be creative and write definition in their own way. That is okay. Okay. But in general, at least the definitions, what I will suggest is that definitions, you have to follow the textbook. The wording of the textbook is more appropriate. Remaining, you know, you can always try to write in your own words. I am not any favor for that one. No problem. Next, for example, this is like the chances that this will be given may be less. You have to draw your own self, okay? The structure of the brain and label the parts, okay? Now, for example, label the parts of the brain. So, now here what is happening? This region, okay? So, one is the cerebellum. Medulla oblongata. Okay, broadly 3 are there. Within this, there are the 4. Correct. Okay. So, for a nice, neat labeling, what a person can do, so you can say like this is A, cerebrum, B, cerebellum, and C, medulla oblongata. So within A, 1, 2, 3, 4 is there. Okay. A is the frontal lobe, parietal, occipital, temporal. Like this you write. Okay. Within A.
So can we use colors?
You can use, but I don't think it is important. You can use if you try. It's okay. If you don't use also, it's okay. The main idea here is that you should be able to show that these are separate regions. There are the 4 regions in the cerebrum.
Yes, sir. That means if we are writing red, then we will write a hyphen, then we will write frontal lobe, and blue, then we will write parietal lobe, like that.
You know, for your printed kind of question paper, color is not expected that you will get colored images in your question paper. For online exam, what happens is that digital copy, you will be getting some colors also. That's a different thing. But when you're writing offline exam, the chances you will get color diagrams is, I think it is rare. It's not. Just a general, it will be grayscale diagram only. So if that is one thing, that image, the diagram is there and you are labeling that one. Most probably, if it is 5 marks question, you may be asked to yourself draw the diagram. Try your best to make a nice diagram, practice a few times, okay, and you can label it. Okay, so in this way you can do. And another important one is like the labeling of that of the neuron, structure of the neuron. So here, for example, what we can do is this is the soma or cell body, and the region from here to here, is the axon. Okay. And specifically, this is the myelin sheath. The gap between this is the nodes of Ranvier. Okay. These are the axon terminal. Okay. This is the neuromuscular junction. And this exactly this end point where, because here muscle is shown, suppose it is between one nerve cell and another nerve cell, okay, between a dendrite of one cell and the nerve ending of another cell, then what we say that one point as
synapse.
Okay, in that case we will say it is the synapse. So in this way, these are like broad, this is a whole region, broad region. Specific region you can show like this in this part, like a dendrite. So that makes the labeling also very neat. Okay, this kind of thing you can follow when you are drawing and labeling, or if already it is made and you are labeling, either way. Okay. So, any other doubts you have in this chapter, nervous system? Let us see.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, can you once please explain the pathway of a reflex arc?
Okay, reflex arc. So what is the meaning of arc? Reflex means, you know, reflex. Something is happening and you are not responding. You are almost like reacting. Okay. You are reacting to it. Okay. So that means the time that is taken for the stimulus and your response is very sharp. When you say that is a response, okay, like sometimes they say don't react, respond. Okay, so don't react means someone told something and immediately something you start speaking. That is a reacting. Okay. Respond means you will listen that one, understand it, okay, and then you will respond to that question or you will respond to that. So here what is happening in a response, the brain is involved, the function of the brain is involved. And in the case of a reflex, okay, there is no involvement of the brain, that the spinal cord itself is processing, because there is a certain training that is involved. Okay, if there is some kind of training is involved, that will be what kind of a reflex?
Conditioned reflex.
Conditioned reflex. Okay, it will be a conditioned reflex if a training is involved, okay, or we can say acquired reflex. And if it is something from birth, it is an inborn reflex. Here it will involve the spinal cord. So in a reflex arc, what is happening is, they will be the spinal cord. Okay, some kind of cross section we are trying to make here. So you can imagine that is some vertebrae, and inside this is the spinal cord. In the spinal cord, the inner region will be gray or the outer region will be gray?
Sir, inner region. Inner region.
Inner region is
so inner region.
So in the brain, what is happening? The outer is the light color, and as we go deep inside the brain, okay, it is in the gray color. Because is that true? In the brain, the outer region is the
gray matter.
Okay, so outside is the gray matter, and as you are going inside, all those axons will be going inwards. Okay, just you can think like some kind of outside it is taking information, inside the wires are going inside, deep inside. So the wires are having the myelin sheath, so they are white. But once we are talking about the spinal cord, it becomes reverse. Inside is the gray matter and outside is the white. Now this spinal cord is in a case of a reflex action, there is some action, no? Action means some motor function should be there. So here we are talking about say some hand is going to perform some function. So the person's hand is there and it is coming in contact with some kind of sharp object, for example. So moving away from the sharp object, there are some nerves that are there in the ends of this hands, fingers, everywhere, right? First point here we say is the receptors. Okay. There are the different types of receptors. Receptors for pain, that is the heat, receptors for touch. Okay, different types of receptors. In the nose it is there for smell, in the mouth it is there for different taste. So receptors are of different types. These receptors are connected to the nerves. And when we are touching a pointed object or a hot object, something like that, so we, through these receptors, we get the signal which is transmitted by the nerves. Which kind of nerve is transmitting? It will go from here to the spinal cord, and from there it has to complete the circuit, okay, and it has to come to the muscles of the hand, so that it can pull the hand away, okay, withdraw the hand. So what are the different neurons that are involved here? The first part, this one is known as the sensory neuron because it is sensing. Simple. And this part of the neuron of the circuit that is going to the muscles and it is going to do some motor activity. That is the motor
neuron.
Both of these are connected in the spinal cord region by a small network that is known as the interneuron. Okay. So that is a simple thing. So receptors that are going to sense it, sensory neurons going to carry the signal to the spinal cord. In the spinal cord, interneurons will connect the sensory neuron to the motor neuron. Okay. Signal will go to the motor neuron that you have to withdraw the hand from here. So in this way, that arc, did we say it is the reflex circuit? We didn't say reflex circuit. We said it's a reflex arc. So arc. So there is a circle, right? And there is an arc. Draw an arc. Arc is something like a part of a circle, short segment of a circle, you can say this is an arc. Semicircle is an arc, okay, small arc. So here what is happening is it a complete circuit? No, it is coming after motor neuron, and is it again going back and connecting with sensory neuron? No. So because the circuit is this way, okay, coming from here, ending here, coming from this hand and ending in the again muscle of the hand, not exactly here where the finger is there. And in between, this is the spinal cord region. So this is a not a complete circuit, it is an arc. So we say it is a reflex arc. Okay. So it is clear? Anything you want to ask in this one?
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, how many types of nervous system can be divided into how many types?
Nervous system can be
divided into how many types?
In our previous class, we have discussed, very nicely in detail, we have discussed a single slide. Okay. Central nervous system.
I was asking.
Central and peripheral nervous system. I also have sent one snapshot also on that group.
Okay. Yes, sir.
You see that?
Yes, sir.
You see that? Okay. So I think if there are no further doubts.
The autonomous nervous system is not included.
It is there. It is there in your book. It is there in the chapter.
Okay, sir.
Okay, thank you. See you all.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Bye, sir. Have a good day.
8A biology.
Injection having the anesthetic will be given in that region. So next